Good day, sir. Good day, classmate. We are the group 2, and for today's video, we're going to discuss customer focus. So, ano nga ba ang customer focus? Customer focus. Customer focus might be the most important principle of quality management. The customer is the ultimate charge of quality goods and services. One of the goals of a company is to satisfy customer needs and wants. Kailangan malaman kung ang product or services na binibigay natin sa customer ay nakakasatisfy ng kanilang needs and wants. The company need to focus on their customer to improve what aspect in their product or service are in need of improvement. Kaya isa ang customer focus sa mga importanteng aspeto ng pagpapatakbo ng isang business. Customer satisfaction. The ASQ defines customer satisfaction as the result of delivering a product or service that meets customer requirements. Customer satisfaction is vital to keeping customers and growing a business. Like what I said earlier, that one of the company's goal is to satisfy customers' needs and wants because customer is what the company needs to flourish the business. The satisfied customer can be a repeat customer and eventually a loyal customer to the company. Loyal customers are the most satisfied clients in your product or services, but it doesn't mean that the company won't improve their product or services. With the rapid improving of everything, ang mga company ay kailangan din makisabay o mag-adapt ng bago o napapanahon para ma-maintain ang customer satisfaction. Customer engagement. Customer engagement is an important outcome of customer-focused culture and the organization, listening, learning, and performance excellence strategy. Customer engagement is the process through which a business establishes a relationship with its customer to develop brand loyalty and recognition brand awareness. Marketing efforts, fresh material developed for and posted to the website and outreach via social media, mobile and wearable devices, among other techniques na makakatulong sa pag-achieve ng customer engagement. Kailangan ito ng isang product or services para makilala at eventually tangkilikin ng market. Identifying customer. The first step in being customer-focused is to understand who your customers are. Most employees think that customers are those people who ultimately purchase and use the company's product. The easiest way to identify customer is to think in terms of customer-supplier relationship. Your company and marketing strategy must include a strategy for identifying and engaging your clients. Obviously, your consumers are the one who purchase from your company. Knowing what they like, how much they are willing to pay, what they enjoy, and what they require can provide you with a better knowledge of what they will want from you, allowing you to transform your product into something that will sell to your target market. At hindi lahat ay potential customer, kaya kailangan malaman kung sino-sino ang potential customer mo.
And now let's proceed to customer segmentation. There are many different ways to approach customer segmentation. Customer segmentation might be based on geography, demographic factors, ways in which product are used, volumes or exit levels of service. So for example, si SM, diba, you want to buy clothes or shoes or kung ano pa man yan. So nasa SM majority lahat. So si SM merong iba't ibang stall ng clothes. May Nike, may SM department store, may Bench, may Human, etc. So technically, maraming choices, mas maganda kasi ang customer natin, halimbawa tayo, hindi naman lahat gusto ng dresses, hindi naman lahat gusto ng nakapants, may nakaskirt, hindi naman lahat gusto ng design ng oxygen, yung iba gusto Bench. So may choices tayo. Kumbaga, more choices, more ma-attract si customer to choose the right clothes that they want. So next is understanding customer needs. At IDEO, one of the world's leading design firms, which designed Apple First Mouse, stand-up toothpaste tube, and many other innovative products design doesn't begin with a far-out concept or a cool drawing. It begins with a deep understanding of the people who might use whatever product or the service that eventually emerge from its work, drawing from anthropology, psychology, biomechanics, and other disciplines. Knowing and understanding customer needs is the center of every successful business, whether it sells directly to individuals or other businesses Once you have this knowledge, you can use it to pursue potential and existing customers that buying from you is in their best interest. For example, sa restaurant, syempre as a customer, I expect a good atmosphere, good service, good food, tamang presyo sa food na in-order ko, yung kung gaano ba kabilis yung service, yung mga ganun. There is an expectation. Next is quality dimension of goods and service. David A. Garvin suggested that the product have multiple dimension quality, so we have 7 of them. The performance, features, reliability, conformance, durability, serviceability, and aesthetic. So first is performance. Ito na yung performance ng isang product. Example sa cellphone, soft touch ba? Maganda ba yung camera, yung speaker, okay ba? Yung software, okay ba? Na-meet ba yung standards mo? Nandun ba lahat? Okay ba lahat? So, all in all yung performance. Okay? So, next is the feature. So, what is the feature of your product? Sa phone, example, sa iPhone, nauso yung Face ID, si Siri, and si iCloud. Third is reliability. Gaano ba siya nagtatagal? Yung totoo. Yung paggamit sa kanya, yung battery lifespan ba ng phone mo, okay pa ba? Syempre, depende naman yan sa gumagamit ng tao, right? So, yun yung calculation or kung gaano talaga katagal aabot sa'yo yung product na yun. Next is conformance. Na-meet ba yung standard service ng product mo? Dun sa phone na yun, meron na ba talagang music? Meron na talagang notes? Yung mga standard na application sa phone mo, nandun ba? Fifth is durability. Patibay ba siya? Water resistance ba siya? Pag ba nabagsak ba siya, mababasag agad, or parang wala lang, parang nabagsak lang. So, ganun. Next is serviceability. Habang tumatagal ba, naglalag na ba yung phone mo? Hindi na ba kasi bilis ng phone mo yung, nung unang beses mo siyang nabili, naglalag na ba, naghahang na ba? May something na bang hindi maganda dun sa phone mo habang tumatagal? So, that is the serviceability. And lastly, the aesthetic. How it looks, yung color niya, minimalist ba, yung size niya, okay ba, handy ba, cute ba, maganda ba, or yung eyes ba ng camera niya, cool ba. So, that's it. That is the 7 multiple dimension quality. So, next is the Kano model of customer's requirements. So, Noriaki Kano, professor of emeritus of the Tokyo University of Science, suggested segmenting customer requirements into 3 groups. Number 1, the satisfier, exciters, or delighters. So, first is the satisfier. Ito yung mga sinasabi nating must-have item. So, basic requirements that customers expected in product or service, may mga features na yung product na alam mong given na kumbaga sa standard features. Kanina in example ko yung phone ko. O, example sa music, diba kadalasan naman talaga sa music parang free lang. Ngayon may bayad na like sa Spotify. So, depende kasi sa phone. So, ang ending, ina-expect mo na andun na dahil standard na siya ng isang product, tapos yung binili mo siya, ay wala pa pala doon. Kailangan pa pala mag-payment, yung mga ganun. So, ang ending, it can be cause of dissatisfied customers. So, second is satisfier. Ito naman yung tinatawag natin wants natin. So, requirements customer expressly says, they want. Ito naman yung mga product na alam ni customers kung ano yung meron at wala sa isang product na gusto niyang bilhin. So, syempre, expecting niya, maybe she did her research do sa product, and once he get that product, she or he is satisfied. Next is, lastly, exciters, delighters, never thought of. So, ito yung mga hindi natin ina-expect. New innovative features that customers do not expect or even anticipate. Ito naman yung, for example, sa sasakyan. Hindi mo alam, meron na pala siyang freebies or doon sa mismong sasakyan na yun, may dashcam na pala, may tablet na pala na parang pinipindot. Sorry, hindi kasi ako maalam sa sasakyan. Or doon sa upuan, di ba, meron na rin parang tablet na pwede kang manood. Yung mga ganon. So, meron silang features na hindi mo ina-expect na ganun kaganda. So, it can cause satisfied or dissatisfied. It depends. Next is gathering the voice of the customer. Customer requirements as expressed in the customer's own term are called the voice of the customers. So, ito na yung feedback, statement natin sa product, sa ano ba yung nasasabi natin doon, yung comments natin. So, dito na po papasok lahat yon kay gathering the voice of the customer. So, common sense lang yan, ano? Like what I said, important ang feedback natin sa isang product. Especially kapag merong nakukulangan tayo sa product or merong excess features na hindi naman nagagamit, na parang hindi naman useful, na pwede nilang tanggalin or pwede nilang palitan. So, lahat yun importante. So, yung mga business owners natin, pinakikinggan din tayo. So, kagaya nga kanina sa diniscuss ko, understanding the needs of the consumer. So, kagaya nga ng example kanina, sabi doon, hindi naman basta ginawa lang na naka-tube yung toothpaste. May reason. Siguro dati hindi naman siya naka-tube, di ba? So, may deep study na nagaganap doon sa paggawa nila ng isang product or sa innovative product na ginagawa nila. So, that's it. That is the gathering the voice of the customer.
Direct customer contacts. In customer-driven organization, top executives commonly visit the customer personally, which means yung employee mismo yung pupunta or kukontak sa customers to know more about their issues and complaints, to make sure na mas maiintindihan nila kung saan ang gagaling yung reklamo ng mga consumers. Also, sa ganitong paraan, mas mag-i-increase yung value ng products and services to customers in purchasing. Field intelligence. Any employee who comes in direct contact with customers such as salespersons, referred technicians, telephone operators, receptionists can obtain useful information simply in engaging in conversation and listening to customers. Kapag ang isang employee is na-engage in communicating to the customers, maaari silang makakuha ng information at mas maintindihan nila ito. In this way, mas matututo silang mag-analyze if ano ba yung kalimitang nagiging issue upang magkaroon ng complaints. And by doing that, alam na ngayon kung paano masusolusyonan ito. For example, sa isang hotel. Napansin nila dito na karamihan sa mga customers ay hindi nagagamit yung mga bath crystals. So they decided na tanggalin na lang yun. Which means saving costs for the consumers. And maglalagay na lang sila ng amenities na mas ginagamit ng mga customers. Next is complaints. Complaints, although undesirable from service point of view, can be a key source of information. Sabi dito sa complaints can be a key source of customer's information. Siyempre, by knowing the customer's point of view, malalaman kung ano ba yung mga bagay na gusto at ayaw nila. Makakapag-adjust ang isang organization because they are hearing or learning about the complaints and still able to correct the problems. For example, if madami nagko-complain in same specific issues in the organizations, can now focus on fixing that kind of problem. Tapos, di ba, may mga feedbacks na galing sa customers. It can be used to improve the products and services. Internet and social media monitoring. The internet and social media such as Facebook offer organizations a fertile arena in finding out what customers think of their products. Using the internet and social media is a great help in finding out the concerns of the consumers. And madaming tao din na nabibigay ng kani-kanilang opinion about the products or services na nabigay na sa kanila. Kaya mas nakakatulong ito sa pagmumonitor. Dito kasi, because we know that a lot of customers also based on what they read on social media. Also, internet can be a good source of information about the competitor's product. Siyempre, di ba, may mga customers na nabibigay ng mga reviews or feedback na maaaring nakita sa internet. Maraming tool na pwedeng gamitin sa pagmamonitor. For example na lang dito is yung analytical marketing tool. It is used to measure the guest engagement. Next, we have the Exhibit 16.5, Customer Listening Post at Nestle Purina Pet Care Company. This details sa 16.5 features, makikita yung wide variety of listening and learning approach for different customer segments. For consumers, refers to pet owners who purchase the products. While for the customers, the retailers that stock and sells products in the stores. Analyzing voice of the customer data. Because of voice of customer data typically consists of large numbers of verbal comments or the other textual information. It needs to be shortened and consolidated into logical groups so that managers can understand the key issues. One of the useful tools of organizing large volumes of information is the affinity diagram, which is the main ingredients of KJ method developed in 1960 by Kawakita Jiro. Exhibit 16.6, the Affinity Diagram.
The affinity diagram is commonly used within a project management and allows large numbers of ideas, starting from brainstorming, to be sorted into groups based on their natural relationship for review and analysis. Actually, kapag nagkaroon ng affinity diagram ang isang organization, pwede nila itong magamit for better designs ng mga products and mas ma-meet nila yung customers' needs. For example, they can be used this to organize and enlarge group complex of ideas or issues, and yun yung mga kailangan nilang gawin ng isang company to be successful to market their products. Linking customers' needs to designs, productions, and service delivery. VOC information must be linked to design, productions, and delivery processes. First is the customer service quality. Customer service quality providing consumers with fast, rapid, and friendly service while developing strong relationship with them. It also requires promptly reacting to consumers' issues and managing complaints. Next is the banking service product quality. Knowing the importance of the service product quality, a bank can differentiate from competitors on the true underlying factors of consumer selections and gain sustained competitive advantage, attracting new clients and building effective long-term relationship with them. Last is the online system quality, content, accuracy, ease of use, timeless, aesthetics, and security. However, ang paggamit ng mga internet banks has been poor in meeting the customer's needs. Maraming nagkakaproblema in terms of processing the requirements through online. One way of understanding the leakage of VOC to internal process is what we call the gap model. This exhibit 16.7 provides a point of view of process in which customers' needs and expectations. These needs and expectation can be also called as expected quality. Ito yung mga ina-expect na matatanggap ng mga customers from the products. Next is yung actual quality, which is the output or outcome ng products na matatanggap ng mga customers. And then yung reviews and perceptions ng customers sa product quality is called the perceptions quality. If the expected quality is higher than the actual quality, the customer will probably be dissatisfied. Well, if the actual quality exceeds the expectation, then the customer will be satisfied. Ang Exhibit 16.7 is nagpapakita na dapat ang isang organization ay kailangan magkaroon ng good communication with the customers. Because a company needs to focus on an overall customer's experience and that impacts perceptions.
Building a customer-focused organization. Creating a customer-focused organization takes hard work and discipline. It must be built on good policies, good people, and good processes. Kasi nga, when we build customer-focused organization, ito yung strategy na priority natin yung mga customer. Sila yung center ng business mo. Ito yung decisions na magkakaroon ng impact yung mga business mo sa mga customers mo. So, it's a long-term strategy that develops loyalty and build trust sa mga customer. So, one of the good example of customer-focused organization is Deer Valley Ski Resort. So, everything about Deer Valley, from its facilities, services, and processes, and the interaction between employees and guests, is designed to focus on the customer. It is no wonder that Deer Valley is constantly rated as the best ski resort in North America by Ski Enthusiast magazine. Customer-focused organizations focus on four key processes. First is making sincere commitments to customer. Next is ensuring quality customer contact. Next is selecting and developing customer contact employees. Last is managing complaints and service recovery. Making sincere commitments to customer. Effective commitments address the principal concerns of customers, are free from conditions that might weaken customers' trust and confidence, and they're communicated clearly and simply to customers. So, ang mga customer ngayon, alam na nila yung good or bad service, and madali na lang sa kanila i-differentiate kung sincere ka ba o hindi. Siyempre, nararamdaman naman nila yun eh. So, once the customer believe that being insincere ka sa kanila, it would be impossible to keep them. And syempre, mahirapan ka ding maka-attract ng new customers. So, syempre, without customers, walang business. So, lugi ka. So, what are the example of sincere commitment? So, ito na nga yung kapag nag-i-inquire sila, dapat syempre, nasasagot mo on time. Hindi yung kinabukasan pa masasagot. So, sino nga ba ang gusto ng ganun, di ba? And lalong-lalo na kapag sinabi mong quality ng service mo. Dapat totoo yun dahil yun yung ini-expect nila, and once nasubukan na nila yung quality talaga, makukuha mo yung trust nila, and syempre nga naman, the customer, they prefer companies na quality yung service and gusto nila na napipil na importante sila. So as you can see, malaki yung epekto ng sincere commitment. So it attract more customer and magkakaroon ka pa ng mga loyal customer. So maraming ways yung pakikipag-interact, diba? Merong face-to-face and meron namang online. And this website called Moment of Truth. Sa Moment of Truth na yun, dun sila nag-perform ng perception about sa quality ng service nila. Usually, ginagawa nila to by comparing sa expectation nila versus sa outcomes. And based sa natanggap nilang service, syempre dun mo marirealize kung satisfy ka ba or hindi. So, for example na nga lang sa Apple Company, ang Moment of Truth nito is, kunwari pumunta ka sa store para i-check yung product and nagustuhan mo. Syempre kapag nagustuhan mo, makikipag-transact ka na, bibilin mo. Tapos syempre ginamit mo na, di ba? And kunwari pag may defect, di ba? Syempre anong gagawin mo? Parang ipapalit mo to, di ba? So, dito nangyayari yung Moment of Truth. So, Google introduced new concept about sa importansya ng initial online experience. So, tinatawag niya itong zero moment of truth. And according dito, 88% ng shoppers, sinecheck muna yung product or yung mga feedback before bilhin. So, kaya masasabi talaga na yung zero moment of truth is importante sa mga customer para mapag-isipan nilang mabuti kung bibili ba or hindi. Walang mga impossible na decision ganun. Customer contact requirements are measurable performance level or expectation that define the quality of customer contact with an organization. So, for example, diba, tumawag ako sa isang company. So, ano nga ba yung response time nila? Naghintay ba ako or na-hold ba ako ng maraming minuto? Or pagkatawag ko ba, meron agad sumagot? Mga ganun. So, dahil dito, na-measure yung quality customer contact. Selecting and developing customer contact employees. Customer contact employees are particularly important in creating customer satisfaction as they often are the only means by which a customer interacts with an organization. Customer contact employees. So, ito yung mga humaharap sa customer. So, dahil sila yung mga humaharap sa customer, importante dito yung behavior and attitudes ng mga employees. Successful service depends on simple action. For example na nga dito is yung pag-greet nyo sa mga guests, pagpasok pa lang, and syempre, samahan nyo ng smile para good vibes na sila kapag dating pa lang. And syempre, di rin mawawala saying thank you and being helpful. So, alam naman natin na importante ito sa industry natin. Kapag nagagawa natin yung mga ganitong bagay, malaki din ang chance na nasasatisfy natin yung mga guests or yung mga customer. Business must carefully select customer contact employee. So, dapat tinitrain nilang mabuti yung mga employee nila. Syempre, para alam nila yung mga proper and etiquette na dapat gawin kapag nakikipag-interact sa mga guests or sa mga tao. And syempre, dahil na-train ka nga mabuti, may exceed mo yung mga expectation ng customer nyo. So, despite of all satisfied customers, syempre in every business, makaka-experience ka pa din ng mga unhappy customers. And syempre, kapag hindi mo na-deal ng maayos, makaka-affect ito sa business mo. That's why yung TARP nag-conduct ng survey. The meaning of TARP is Technical Assistance Research Programs. They conducted studies that revealed the following information. So first is the average company never hears from 96% of its unhappy customer. Dissatisfied individual and business customers tend not to complain. For every complaint received, the company has 26 more customers with problems, 6 of whom have problems that are serious. So sa number 2 naman is more than half na nag-complain is makikipag-business pa din sila. So if the complaint is nasolusyonan agad, so 95% pa din is magpa-purchase. And yung iba naman is ang result naman na syempre negative word of mouth, so sasabihin na nila yun sa iba yung feedback nila. So yung service recovery is importante sa pag-maintain ng customer relationship. Kasi nga 'di ba may mga customer na hindi nasa-satisfy. So customer recovery, so ito yung act na pagtama sa mga maling service or sa mga poor service. Ito yung process na i-recover mo yung mga hindi magandang karanasan na serbisyo ng mga customer. So, the key is to react as fast as you can para makuha mo ulit yung mga tiwala ng customer. So, this is a vital element para mapanatili natin yung mga customer. So, yung mga loyal customer, most likely ang hindi nasasatisfied kapag hindi na solve agad yung issue nila. Kasi nga, di ba, loyal customer sila, tapos biglang ganon. Pero sila din yung most likely natataas yung loyalty nila kapag na-resolve yung problem na okay. Tapos yung mga non-loyal customer, mas lalo silang hindi magiging loyal kapag hindi na-resolve agad yung issue nila. Kaya based sa study, mas okay na mag-response ka sa or mag-service ka sa mga non-loyal customer kapag may mga complain. Kasi nga yung mga loyal customer is loyal na. Hindi mo man ma-resolve agad yung problem nila, may chance na bumalik pa sila sa service mo. And yung mga non-loyal customer is malabo na ang chance na bumalik pa sila. So, yung customer focus organization, so kinukonsider nila yung complaint as opportunity for improvement. So, hindi siya hindrance sa organization. Kasi nga naman, kapag may complaint, malalaman mo yung mga mali sa business mo. So, alam mo na kung ano yung mga gagawin. And syempre, kapag naayos mo na mabuti yung complaint, gaya nga ng sabi ko kanina, may chance na mas tumaas pa yung loyalty ng customer mo. And ang example na nga dito is sa Walmart. So, yung Walmart, ito yung pinakasikat na store sa US. So, yung customer is tumawag sa headquarters ng Walmart para mag-complain. Tapos, yung call na yun is dumiretso agad sa vice president. So, nag-thank you naman yung vice president dahil tumawag siya about dun sa concern. And itong VP naman, nagtanong ng detailed question. Tapos, tinanong din niya kung pwede bang ulitin niya yung story na to sa Latinian VP. Tapos, edi yun nga, pumayag siya. So, transfer siya dun. Tapos, and syempre, tinanong din siya ng Latinian VP. So, sinabi niya ulit yung complaint niya. And yun nga, after nila mag-usap about sa complaint, after years later, pagbalik niya sa store na yon, yung mga complaint niya is inayos na. So, kinoconsider yung complaint niya. So, syempre, yun nga, kapag ikaw, kinonsider yung complaint mo, matatouch ka, diba? So, dahil doon, mas tumaas yung loyalty. Many organizations have well-defined process for dealing with complaints. So, the basic steps are record the incident, investigate, and then, syempre, tsaka mo identify, review, and implement mo yung correct na action. Next naman is sa pag-deal ng complaint, syempre, kailangan mo silang pakinggan. Pakinggan mo yung sinasabi nila and mag-respond ka sympathetically. So, ibig sabihin, parang ilagay mo yung sarili mo sa sitwasyon nila. And syempre, sabihin mo, naiintindihan mo sila by saying na, I understand that you're having this problem, chuchubels, and I'm willing to help you, parang ganun. Para may assurance sila na tutulungan mo sila.
So, by examining trends in customer satisfaction measures and linking satisfaction data to its internal process, a business can see its progress and areas for improvement. So, once na alam mo kung ano yung feedback ng customers mo sa business mo, you'll be able to know whether you have to improve something inside your business. And good customer satisfaction measurement identifies processes that have high impact on satisfaction and distinguishes between low-performing processes and those that are performing well. Kung maayos yung mame-measure yung customer satisfaction sa iyong business, malalaman mo kung ano yung mga processes na nakakapag-satisfy sa kanila. One way to evaluate customer satisfaction and use it effectively is to collect information on both the importance and the performance of key quality characteristics, or in simple terms, the features of a product or service that matter most to the customer. One example is, a hotel might ask how important check-in speed, check-out speed, and staff attitude, and so on. So, dapat you know kung gaano ba ka-importante sa mga customers mo yung mga features na bumubuo sa business mo, and kung nasasagawa ba ito ng maayos within your business. And the result of such analysis can help target areas for improvement and cost savings, as well as provide useful input for strategic planning. So often, competitor data are also plotted, providing a comparison against the competition. That's where you also gather data from other businesses so that you can compare them to yours. Para malaman mo kung napag-iwanan ka na ba or nauuna ka sa competition. Why many customer satisfaction efforts fail? So, do you have any idea kung bakit yung business mo or yung ibang mga business ay nagfe-fail pa rin kahit nagbibigay na sila ng todo effort to satisfy their customer? Well, this may be the reasons why. So, first is poor measurement schemes. So, this is when you only have the feedback of satisfied to very satisfied customers. Kasi mostly yung mga dissatisfied customers ay hindi naman sumasagot sa ating mga surveys. And because of that, business owners are not able to identify na may nadi-disappoint na pala sila na customers and yung reason kung bakit. And then second is failure to identify appropriate quality dimension. So this is when the service address issues that the company think are important and not what the customers think. Yung error na to ay nagre-resulta sa pagkukulang sa pagkuha ng mga information sa kung ano ba talaga ang mga needs and expectations ng ating mga customers. So, third is failure to weigh dimensions appropriately. Ito yung kahit na may measure na ng company yung mga tamang reasons kung paano masatisfy ang customers is sa pinakamababang percentage sila nagpo-focus. So, dahil doon, mas nakakapag-effort tayo sa mga bagay na hindi naman masyadong importante sa ating mga customers. And fourth is lack of comparison with leading competitors. So, without the right data of other businesses, hindi mo mapag-ipagkukumpara ng tama yung progress nila sa progress mo. And you will not know na baka napag-iiwanan ka na pala. Fifth is failure to measure potential and former customers. So, without an understanding kung ano ba yung reason kung bakit walang pumapasok sa business mo or umaalis yung mga former customers, mas malaki yung risk na bumagsak yung market share mo sa competitors and maaaring mamatay na lang yung business mo. And last but not the least, confusing loyalty with satisfaction. So, minsan, we are confused with what's the difference between loyalty and satisfaction. So, ang pinagkaiba nila is yung loyalty relates to the future and yung satisfaction relates to the present.